This tiny teach is about the electron transport chain. The electron transport chain is located on the cell membrane in prokaryotes and on the inner mitochondrial membrane in eukaryotes. So far, glycolysis and the Krebs cycle have netted 4 ATP molecules from 1 molecule of glucose. Therefore, the electron carriers NADH and FADH2 have most of the energy extracted from glucose. The electron transport chain is a collection of molecules embedded in the membrane. Most of the members of the electron transport chain are proteins. NADH transfers its electrons to the first member of the electron transport chain. FADH2 drops its electrons off a little farther down the chain. The flow of electrons down the chain is highly energetic and allows the active transport of hydrogen ions across the membrane. Basically, this means most of the members of the electron transport chain are extracting energy from the electrons as they're passed down the chain and use the energy they extract to push hydrogen ions across the membrane, forming a hydrogen ion concentration gradient across the membrane. Oxygen is the final member of the chain, and the electrons combine with oxygen and hydrogen to form water. If we go back to the overall equation for cellular respiration, we now know the role of oxygen is it's the final electron acceptor in the electron transport chain, and water is a product of the electron transport chain. When the non-energetic electrons combine with oxygen and hydrogen to produce water. Okay, let's get back to the electron transport chain. A hydrogen ion concentration gradient, more hydrogen ions on one side of a membrane than on the other side of the membrane has been formed. What's the purpose of that gradient? ATP production via ATP synthase. ATP synthase is a protein complex, an enzyme that actually makes ATP. Basically, the hydrogen ions will flow back through a small opening in the center of the ATP synthase, and the force of them flowing back through will be used to phosphorylate ADP to produce ATP. For each NADH that enters the electron transport chain, 3 ATP will be produced. For each FADH2 that enters the electron transport chain, 2 ATP will be produced. Because FADH2 drops its electrons off farther down the chain, a smaller hydrogen ion concentration gradient is built, so less ATP is produced. We produce 10 NADH in glycolysis in the Krebs cycle. Since 3 ATP are produced for each NADH, we're going to produce 30 ATP. We produced 2 FADH in the Krebs cycle. Since 2 ATP are going to be produced for each of those FADH2, we're going to produce 4 total ATP. So here in the electron transport chain, we're going to make a total of 34 ATP. Sometimes the electron transport chain seems like a whole lot of drama, but we just made 34 ATP. In glycolysis in the Krebs cycle, we only made 4 ATP total. A whole lot of drama? Yes. Worth it? Definitely.